Hello everyone. Now we will know about the digital signature. What is the digital signature and how exact it work with a different type of algorithm? That one is a digital signature standard, or it may be the RSA approach. When this send a message between two user, the authentication is not sufficient. That why it is need why it is needs more than authentication. It is a digital signature. Digital signature standard, that one is how exact digital signature is useful. That one is already explained in a previous lecture, or it may be the what is the digital signature in a information security. Now how exact it work, we will know about that. Digital signature standard first, that one is a DSS makes use of secure hash algorithm. That one is a digital signature standard is one approach for digital signature. It contains a hashing, right? Now the DSS presents a new digital signature technique, digital signature algorithm. That one is a, we can say that digital signature algorithm. This is the one thing. And the DSA is based on RSA. DSA is based on RSA. Right, RSA, that one is a reverse Shamir-Adelman algorithm, is a asymmetric algorithm, which one is used for, reversely used for the digital signature algorithm. This is the theory behind the RSA approach. Now the how exact it work, that is simply the RSA approach is, this is the RSA approach process. We can go with the points. This one is the RSA approach. And this one is the DSS, digital signature algorithm. Now how exact RSA approach is means its work, then is firstly the consider allies send a message to Bob, right? That one is this message sent to the Bob. In between that message, which one is sent by the allies, which is firstly apply, M is a message, that is a message is concat with the hash value. Means a message given to the input to the hash function. It may be the any hash algorithm like SHA, MD5 or multiple hashing algorithm is available. It generates the message digest or the hashing code. Then it that hash value, which one is encrypted with the encryption algorithm, that one is again this asymmetric algorithm is RSA. Now again this message and the particular encrypted message digest of that message is concat and sent to the Bob. Then message and the encrypted message digest, that Bob apply the hash function on the received message and generate its own hash function, right? Hash value, which is here. We can say that hash value is the H, right? This H is here H, then this H and generated hash value is equal, then the received message is that one is again the hash value. We need to again decrypt that hash value, received hash value, that is a decryption, right? And then H dash is come, or the H is come, then the created hash value and the received hash value both are the equal, then we can say that the message is integrity is message authentication is done with the user authentication also. Because of this, sender's private key, and the sender's public key. Okay, this is the RSA algorithm. Now encryption done with the RSA algorithm, sender's private key. Normally RSA encryption done with the public key. and the RSA decryption done with the private key. But this is the reverse process. This one is the reverse process. Encryption done with the private key and decryption done with the public key. That is simply the process under the RSA approach of a digital signature. And because of these keys, it's verified with the user authentication also, and with the help of hash function, it verifies with the message authentication also. This is simply the RSA approach of a digital signature. Now the next approach, that is digital signature algorithm, that is how exact it work, that one is represented with the next diagram. This one is simply the RSA approach. We will just to use the, this is the RSA approach, sorry, this is the digital signature approach, digital signature algorithm, and this one is the RSA approach. Now how exact the particular digital signature algorithm is work, that is message is just to concat with hash value. What is the hash value? But that hash value have applying a, not encryption, that is applying a, some signing process, right? That signing process have an input of a, some of the random number, sender's private key, which is available in the RSA approach also, and the global public key. Means additionally, it add the global public key and the random number for the signing process, for the hash value. Now the particular user, second Bob, Bob receives the three value, that is a message, S value and R value. That signing generates a value, that is S and R. Okay. Now that this hash message apply a hash value, hash function, give the input to the hash function, then that hash value, then S value, then R value, then global public key, sender's public key, right? These are the five input to the verification process. These are the five input to the verification process. And then it generates a V. It generates a V value, right? V. If V is same as a R value, which is the received by the sender, then we can say that user authentication or the received message from the particular user, that is allies. That is simply the use of digital signature standard or the digital signature algorithm. Then how the global public key is distributed, that is a globally. Allies and Bob receives the global public key from the global server, we can say that. Then random secret, which one is again the selected by key, selected by the allies, and sender's private key and sender's public key, that one is already as it is, we already understood under the RSA algorithm. This is simply the process of the digital signature algorithm. Now we will go with the step by step how exact it work, signing and verification process of a digital signature algorithm. Now the digital signature, that one is it's a digital signature algorithm. Choose an n bit prime number, that is a n bit prime number q, just to select the q. That q is the n bit, that n bit is greater than or equal to hash output length. Means when we use the hash value, it may be if we use the SHA 1, that is the hash value is a 128 bit, right? Then we need to use the n, means a q is more than the, choose an n bit prime number q, and n is the less than this hash output length, means a 128 bit is a hash value, hash size, then the q is less than that. That is the first rule to select the q. Then 160 bit as a prime number, or it may be the you can select the 160, and then when we use this 160, when we use the 256 bit of a message types, simple. Now the second step, that is a prime number P, length between 512 and 1024 bits. Then select the P as a prime number, which one is a size between the 512 and the 102 bit. That is the Q is divided by P minus 1. That is the condition to select the P. Now the third step, that one is calculate the G. G is equal to, H is the hash function. Then input is P minus 1 divided by Q mod P. Then H is a integer between, is an integer between 1 and the P minus 1. That is the by default value, which one is mathematical comes under the digital signature algorithm. That H is the value between the 1 and the P minus 1. Okay, then raised to P minus 1 divided by Q mod P. That generates a G value. That generates a G value. G must be a greater than 1. That is the condition. Now the fourth, that is private key X, which is the less than Q and greater than 0. Then select the public key. That is how to calculate the public key. Y is equal to G raised to X mod P. P that is calculated or selected in a second step. That is it generates sum of the value. Now we got the P, Q, G and Y, right? That one is simply the public key, private key. Then it's a G value. We can say that the G value and the Y value. Oh, sorry, G value and the public key is X, Y, P, Q, G. That is a P, Q and G with our step 1, 2, 3 and Y. That all the four values considering as a public key. All the four values considering as a public key here. Then private key, that is simply the X is a private key. Now the signing process. What exact the signing? Then signing, it's simply the next step. Signing and verification. Now how exact the sign the particular steps, a random value, that is the K, which is less than Q and the greater than 0. Then calculate the R. To calculate the R, that one is a G raised to K mod P mod Q. This is the formula to calculate the R. It's a algorithm steps. Now the calculate the S, R and S value, which means we want to send to the second user with the help of we are to the generating the signing algorithm, we can say that, or signing steps that generates the R and S value. Calculate the R and S with the given formula. That one is S is the K inverse H of M. This is the actual original message. This is the hash function, right? Now plus that one is H of M plus is the X and the R. That one is X into R, right? X is the secret key and the R is the this value. Now it's all value mod Q. Then it generates the two value R and S. And then both value combinedly we can say that that is a signature. This is simply the digital signature algorithm signing process. Now the verification means what? Or verifying this R and S value and the message sent to the second user, that is a Bob. Then if a particular R is the less than Q or S is the less than Q, you can directly reject the signature. It's again the mathematics behind that. It's R and Q is not less than R and S is not less than Q. Okay. Now the W or verifying process is, if it is, this is a reject the signature if this condition, right? If it is not, then go with the verification process. W is equal to S inverse mod Q. S is a received value. Then H of M dash is not a received message, right? Just to calculate the hash value, then multiply with the W value mod Q. We got the U1. Now for U2, R dash, that one is this R dash into W mod Q, then R is the received value, then it generates a U2. Now the V is equal to G raised to U1 into G is the value which one is selected in the step 3. Now the into Y raised to U2 mod P mod Q, we got the V, right, at the second user side of the second user. The signature is valid if V is equal to R dash, or it may be a received of R value, then the signature is valid or the user is authenticated user. This is simply the digital signature under the digital signature for the user authentication and the message authentication, we can say that. Thank you.